Hello, I'm Dr. Pratibha Shetty, working at Nano Hospitals as a consultant gastroenterologist for the past 2 years. And I deal with all the problems related to the gastrointestinal system, starting from the oral cavity up to the anus. To mention, it is the food pipe, the stomach, the small intestine, large intestine, the liver, gallbladder, and pancreatic diseases. So, I would like to tell you a few problems which we commonly suffer during our lifestyle problems. So the major problems are acute gastroesophageal reflux disease, what we call as GERD or reflux of acid. What happens is usually due to our lifestyle, eating all sorts of food and not having a regular schedule of our diet, we usually develop the symptoms where we get the heartburn and throat irritation secondary to reflux of acid from the stomach. So for these problems, we usually, I see such patients and we usually advise patients to change their lifestyles, and a few medications will help their problems. But sometimes this disease may become more serious, for which we may have to diagnose how much of injury has happened inside. So for this we need to do an endoscopy where we directly visualize the food pipe and the stomach using a scope endoscope, or what we call a long fiber optic scope with a camera fitted in the tip of it. So in this we can find out how much of injury has happened to the food pipe and how long should we give the treatment. So this is an important problem which we usually address in the general public. The next disease which usually comes down is acid peptic disease or gastritis, where patients usually have a lot of pain in the abdomen before eating or after eating, and also they have usually need to eat a lot of food with more frequently, so that the acid gets a little calmed. So what happens here is usually the most common thing is a H. pylori infection, where the stomach is infected with this bacteria, and this goes on proliferating or goes on multiplying in the stomach till it has been treated. So what we do here is we do an endoscopy and have a look at the stomach, and then we take a small piece or what we call a biopsy and test for the infection. Once the infection is diagnosed, we can give the appropriate medicines and the patients can be cured. If this treatment has not been done, patient will not be cured for even years together, and they will suffer quite serious consequences in terms of lifestyle and their diet. They will not be able to take the normal diet as usual. So the next common disease is the liver disease, which we call as fatty liver disease, which now the most common is due to non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, or what we call as just with fatty liver disease, where these patients develop a lot of deposition of fat in their liver. Then it may be secondary to many problems. Most common is diabetes or patients who have abnormal cholesterol in their blood. So in such patients, we usually see how much of the liver has been damaged by doing a few tests like ultrasound scan and fibro scan, and then we have a few medicines which will help these patients to get cured. And this is very important because non-alcoholic fatty liver disease can lead to an end-stage liver disease, which may later require liver transplant, or it can be life-threatening. The other diseases are pancreatitis, where the pancreas get inflamed secondary to either gallstone or intake of alcohol. So for those patients, these patients need admission. They also need definite injections and other medicines to help their symptoms improve. And the other major problem which we address here is IBS or irritable bowel syndrome, where the patients have a lot of bloating. Some people have either diarrhea or constipation, and they always have some problem, will not be tolerating some types of foods. So in such patients, we make a diagnosis, and we have many types of medications or a change in lifestyle and dietary therapy to help them improve their symptoms and have a better quality of life. So like this, we have many more diseases in the GI system which we are treating here at Nano Hospital. And we also do a lot of therapeutics, like we remove the gallbladder, bile duct stones by doing endoscopic retrograde cholangiopancreatography, and we do a stenting. We also do colonoscopies. We do enteroscopy, capsule enteroscopy, where the small intestine is evaluated for any problem like bleeding or any tumor or any ulcers. So we have a comprehensive gastrointestinal evaluation at Nano Hospital. And I'm proud to say that I'm associated with this place. Thank you.